I am Mr. True. In this video, we're going to be factoring out a monomial from a polynomial. What we're going to do is we're going to find the GCF. Now that means that we're going to look at all the coefficients, all of the numbers, and look at those numbers and find the biggest number that divides into all of the coefficients evenly. That's going to be numerically the GCF. Then, if any of the terms share a common variable, we're going to use the lowest exponent that we can find for that common variable. So like if all of your terms have an x in them, maybe one has an x to the fifth and one has an x squared, we'll be able to take out the lowest exponent, or x squared. Once we decide and work out what the GCF is, we're going to go ahead and divide that out, or your teacher may be calling it, undistribute that GCF. You should be learning this just after you learn the distributive property or multiplying polynomials together. And so we're doing the opposite, so we're going to undistribute that GCF. And then if your problem is a bit more advanced, and they will be in following videos, then you're going to want to continue to look at what you have left and factor. You can, take more than one step to get your polynomial completely factored. With this video, we're just doing the monomials. We're just pulling those out or undistributing those. So we're not going to have any additional steps, I don't believe, in the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 examples we're back to about to work through. So let's get to those examples. Bam! Okay, first example, we have 2x cubed plus 10. Now, these two terms both have a factor of 2. I'm not going to write all these examples like this, I don't think, but we can write 2x cubed plus 2 times 5, where I'm taking that constant and showing you that both the first term has a factor of 2, and so does the second. So if both of your terms have a common factor, a GCF, then that's what you're going to want to take out. Now, this has 3 x's to give up, but the second term doesn't have any, so I can't take any x's out. These two terms don't have any common variables, but I can take out that value of 2. So if I identify this GCF, identify it and undistribute it. That means that we're not going to multiply it through the parentheses, we're going to divide it out. And you'll start to mentally do this in your head, but when you're first learning out or learning this concept, you might want to show that division. So we're going to write 2x cubed divided by what we feel our GCF is, what we can factor out of all of the terms in this polynomial. So we're going to divide that by 2 and 10 divided by 2. So we're taking that GCF of 2 out of those two terms. And this multiplication, of course, is the inverse operation of this division. So these math operations are just balancing out. It's just making the polynomial look different. It's not changing its value. So 2 divided by 2 is 1, so we have 2 times x cubed, and 10 divided by 2 is equal to 5. Voila! While we're learning factoring, the first purpose of learning factoring in your Algebra 1 or Algebra 2 course, or whatever you happen to be in, is it helps you solve equations, find out where they cross the x-axis, find the roots, the zeros, the solutions, whatever your textbook is calling it. And it will have other purposes later on in mathematics, but initially after this you're going to be learning it or using this skill for solving equations. Here we have 6x squared plus 15x. Now, both of these terms have a common variable, so we're going to pull an x out, and we're going to pull out, we're going to look through this and find, okay, where is the lowest exponent? Well, that lowest exponent on the variables is the x, so we're going to be able to take out where's my yellow chalk at? Here we go. We're going to be able to take out an x. Now, between the 6 and the 15, do they share a common factor? If they do, is it the biggest common factor that they both share? Like if your two numbers are 12 and 24, 12 and 24 both have a factor of 2, they both have a factor of 3, they both have a factor of 4, but your biggest factor, your biggest common factor, 6 as well, but your biggest common factor would be 12. So you want to identify what can divide evenly into both of those coefficients and use the largest number that you can factor out of both. And 6 and 15 share a common factor of 3, and that's it. So we're going to take that 3 and divide it out. So we have 6x squared divided by 3x plus 15x divided by 3x. And again, once you start to comfortably and consistently get these right, you can skip this step, maybe if your teacher allows you to start to do more of this in your head. We have 3x, and then 6 divided by 3 is 2. and x squared divided by x. Now, I haven't done, I worked, made a video for properties of exponents dealing with multiplication and the power rule, but I haven't done the quotient rule yet. So hopefully you have in your class, you have some experience here with this, but we have x squared, that means there's two x's on the top, and we have one x in the denominator. Well, one of those x's, let's rewrite this, since I know I haven't covered, sorry for the interruption. Let's go to rewrite that x squared as x times x, because it's kind of bothering me just a little bit that I haven't covered the quotient rule or the division rule for exponents. If you write that x as x squared, then you can see that our, let's pick a different color here, that x divided by x is going to be equal to 1. So those that 2 on the top, and you're taking the 1 out through the division, is only going to leave you with 1x left over. So we have 6 divided by 3 is 2, and x squared divided by x is 1x. Then 15 divided by 3 is 5. And I'm starting to write the x, but they are going to cancel out. Anything divided by itself is equal to 1. So there we go. If you want to check this answer, like, you know, maybe you haven't dealt with dividing exponents very much yet, and you want to check your work, you can always just take this and multiply it back through and make sure that it matches. 3 times 2 is equal to 6. X times x is equal to x squared. Remember, when you multiply those like bases, you add the exponents, and there's little unseen exponents of 1 there. And then 3x times 5 is equal to 15. X, and indeed that is what we started off with. Now, we're going to step up the difficulty a little bit in these examples as we go through them, as always. 9 and 21. I'm going to go ahead and take a negative number out. It doesn't really maybe matter. It depends on what your teacher wants. I'm going to go ahead and take a negative out just to change that the sign of that first term. And between 9 and 21, the largest common factor is 3, so we're going to take out a negative 3. Now, in this one, I have more than just one variable, so I need to look at the x's and the y's separately. Both of these terms have an x, so I can take, you know, that x out. If only the first one had an x and the second one did not, then I would be moving just to the move on to the y variable to see if I can factor that out of, or divide that out of each of those terms. But this has 5 to give up, and this has 2. I can't take more than any one of the terms have, so again, I need to take that lowest number of x squared. And this has 4 y's to give up, this has 7, so we're going to take 4 of those out. And again, we're undistributing or dividing out these GCFs. So we got negative 9, x to the 5th, y to the 4th over 3, negative 3, x squared, y to the 4th. Plus 21 x squared y to the 7th, and we're going to divide that by negative 3 x squared y to the 4th. Okie dokie. So we have negative 3 x squared y to the 4th. Negative 9 divided by negative 3 is 3. We have 5 x's, and we're taking 2 of those out, so that's going to leave us with 3. Again, 2 of these x's in the denominator are going to cancel out with 2 of those x's in the numerator, and there's 5 up there, so you're going to be left with 3. And anything divided by itself is equal to 1, so this is going to just cancel out, and we have 3x cubed. Now, there is a plus sign there, and I almost just said plus, but as you work through your problems, you should be doing the math as you go, and just don't start, you know, putting down your signs all over the place. I mean, you know, we're dealing with positive and negatives. You want to make sure those signs are right. So, you know, before you just write without thinking, positive 21 divided by negative 3 is negative 7. Now, you can write a plus negative 2, but I like to just use the single sign. So 21 divided by negative 3 is negative 7. X to the second divided by x to the second is going to be, that's just going to cancel out. I'm going to go ahead and cross these out as well. And this has 7 y's, and you're taking 4 of them out. That's going to leave you with 3. And that problem is factored. I got 2 more examples to finish this video. All right. 5x to the 4th minus 7x cubed plus 18x. Now, at this example, I don't have any common factors between 5 and 7. They're both prime. And neither one of those numbers go into 18. I just don't want you to think you can always factor out a number in a variable. So 5, 7, and 18 do not share any common factors. However, all three terms have an x in them. So I can take an x out of all three. This has 4 to give up, 3 to give up, and only 1 to give up. So that's what we're going to take out. So we have x. Now, I'm just going to take this out, kind of skip this step of writing the division. If I have 5x to the 4th and I'm taking that one of those x's out through division, that's going to leave me with 3x's. So this is going to be 5x to the 3rd minus 7x squared. I have 3 in here and I'm taking one of them out through division. And then plus 18, well, this term only has 1x, and I'm taking it out, I'm dividing it out, and it's now in front of the parentheses, so that's it. If you want to check it, just take that x and distribute it back through. Sorry for the interruption. School's out and my contract day is over and they're still on the intercom. 4x cubed plus 12x minus or to the negative 2 power. This is a bit of a bonus question if you're just in, say, Algebra 1, and maybe not even your Algebra 2 book might not have this, I'm not sure. But I'm adding this because I teach pre-calculus and I'm getting my brushing off my skills for calculus and posting videos for that as well. And there's a lot of instances where you need to factor out a monomial, but some of your exponents are negative. You might not even learn that yet about negative exponents and how to deal with them. Probably it's coming up soon if you haven't. I'm going to work through this anyway. Just call it an extra credit problem. These two terms, these leading coefficients, both have a factor of 2, but they also both have a factor of 4. Of course, that's bigger, so we're looking for the GCF. Both of these terms also have a variable of x. So we can take that common x out that's in both of those terms. But it's a little bit weird that one of our exponents is negative. Remember, in your directions I said, for common variables you want to take out the lowest exponent. And negative 2 is less than 3. So we're going to factor out that 4x to the negative 2. So that's going to be 4x cubed divided by 4x to the negative 2 plus 12x to the negative second power over 4x to the negative second power. Okay, well, that's going to be 4x to the negative 2. Anything divided by itself is 1, so those 4s are going to cancel out. And when you divide like bases, again, I'm getting ahead of myself a little bit because I haven't taught the video or taught you how to the quotient or the division property of exponents, but when you divide like bases, you're supposed to subtract those exponents. The opposite of when you multiply like bases, you add those exponents. So x to the third divided by x to the negative 2 is x to the 3 minus negative 2. I'm doing that subtraction down as we normally would, and we're subtracting that negative exponent. Now, subtracting a negative is, basically those two negatives are going to multiply together and give us an addition. Plus, 12 divided by 4 is 3, and again, anything divided by itself is equal to 1, so that just is 3. We have 4x to the negative 2. 3 minus negative 2 is the same as 3 plus 2, so that's going to be 3 plus 2 is 5. So we have x to the 5th plus 3. Now, again, I don't know if you've studied negative exponents or not yet. If you haven't, it probably is coming up soon. We don't like to leave negative exponents in our final answer. So this base that has the negative exponent, we're going to move that to the bottom of this. Now, there isn't a fraction that just looks like a single line of algebra here, but we're going to create a fraction by taking this base with the negative exponent and floating it down to the bottom because I want to change that negative exponent to a positive exponent. I explain in another video exactly why that happens, or give a couple of examples of why or how that happens, but for now we're just going to say the 4 and the x to the 5th plus 3 stays in the numerator, and the x to the negative 2, well, we're going to drop that x to the denominator so its exponent becomes positive, and that's our answer and our final example. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.